for kind of, you know, throwing it together as far as the timing of the week and everything else. Yeah, we would have liked to have played on Saturday, but I thought our team did a really good job today. Coach Bowl always had a standard. He always said on spring games, he's like, make it look like football. And really, by and large, I thought today, you know, it looked like football. And when you're dividing up teams that way, and you know, you got kind of mixed match of people, sometimes it can look kind of ugly. And that really didn't today. I mean, it was good though. We had a lot of things that show up situationally and show up in the course of a game where, you know, had younger guys that we're going to need to count on that had to play a game. You know, Nate Geiger, Jake Davies, Chris Durr, you know, all these guys had to play games. You know, I thought the mechanics as far as getting plays in and stuff like that went fairly well. We had a couple ball handling things. We fumbled the ball a couple times. You know, that's something that you got to clean up there a little bit. I thought we had a couple questionable, yeah, I'm a defensive coach too a little bit, but we had a couple questionable holds in the perimeter offensively, kind of, you know, disrupted a couple drives, everything that way. But I thought all in all, it went really well. I think it was a really good crowd out there today too, for throwing that together on a 3:30 on a Thursday with all the notice that people had. I thought that went really well. You know, kind of the decision that went into not playing a game on Saturday, you know, it's kind of weather-based in that regard. And the fact that, people would be stunned if they knew how much money it cost to pack the team up and go over to Cheyenne and do that. And we were going to do it. There wasn't a problem that way of doing it. But, you know, in the spring, look, there's a time and a place for everything. And in the spring, I don't really like having players on a lot of wet fields, because that's also where somebody gets poor footing, gets an injury, something like that. Look, when we got to go play in wet and cold and things like that, we'll be out in it and doing it and practicing things like that. But in April, that's not the goal. Today couldn't have went any better for I think what we need to get done.
12 catches, 121 yards for Chris Durr. Safe to say he's a true freshman that might play right away?
Yeah, you know, I had a talk with him in my office today. He's got really, really, really good ball skills, and it's natural. The ball just kind of absorbs into his hands really well. I told him, I said, he's gonna tell me how ready he is to play when he goes home next weekend and comes back 3 weeks later, based on what his weight is at and those types of things there. He'll tell me whether he's ready to play or not. On the field, he's ready to play. We need to get another 8 pounds on him, 8 to 10 pounds on him in the summer and do that. But he's a really good young man, has a great attitude, is really enjoying Wyoming. I mean, he loves being here. It was a really good conversation with him this morning. And then, you know, you also realize the fact that, like, I'm letting him come back a week late for summer training because he's going to graduate high school while he's back. So it's kind of funny that way when you get to that point. But he showed up today and he's got a lot of game to him. He'll definitely be an impact force, provided he does the things that he needs to do, you know, when he's away from here and comes back. Everything. So DJ Jones, you know, look, there's I thought when we went in to finish the recruiting cycle in December and with where our football team was right now, or at least at that point in time, and what we had coming back, and I thought we had a good football team coming back, that, you know, yes, we continue to be a developmental and build for the future and the whole thing. When we had a chance to grab a couple of the transfers that we grabbed that fit the the profile and kind of the criteria that we're always looking for. We don't shoot in the dark on it. Like, it's got to be something that's we know the character, we know all those things. Now, I had no idea DJ Jones was going to be who he was until after he was here about 3 weeks. And then all of a sudden you realize this guy's uber competitive, really mature. And, you know, we gave him a lot more run at running back today because we needed to see him. He needed to play live, and he needed to hit holes, and he needed to make cuts, and he needed to do some of those things. And he did it pretty well, I thought. So big fan of him.
Jay, even though there's a lot of backups out there, I mean, what does it mean to see Evan throw a dime and just kind of end on a positive note? Like,
yeah, it was a good ball. You know, I mean, I think for him, you know, the biggest part of it is that, I mean, that was a ball right there, that's all I can say. I thought he played pretty well. I did. I think, you know, we had a drop the second series that would have got a first down, and you know, once you get a first down, you can kind of get in a little bit of movement and rhythm and everything else. And we had a penalty on one. Next thing you know, they're at 2nd and 15, and it just kind of hurt some things. But that last, he had some really good field throws, right? And that's always one of the things as a defensive coach. If you can kind of pack it in the paint, using a basketball term, because a quarterback can't get the ball all over the field, it really helps you defensively. But when a quarterback can throw an outcut at the depths that he can, and a quarterback can, you know, laser a ball on a seam the way he did right there, you know, there's some good things that can happen then. So.
This spring, I know you have one practice left, but overarching, what are your thoughts on the spring, what you guys got accomplished, just the body of work overall?
Yeah, the body of work was really, really good. I think if you look at the body of work to it, I think we've got, I think some of the things that we had have enhanced a little bit. I think our defensive line is doing a good job. I think we've got the ability to pressure, you know, a quarterback multiple ways, but also the fact that our defensive ends are healthy, and you see that they're healthy and they're bigger. You know, Braden Siders is a way different player right now than he was at any time last year. Sebastian Harsh is 18 pounds bigger than he was at any time last year, and he's also more explosive. And so you're kind of looking at that and you feel, okay, there's positives there. And we've got experience a lot of different places. The defense kind of has a big tool belt that they can run because they've run all this stuff for a while. I thought offensively, you know, the more they learned the system and everything, and I thought our offensive coaches did a really good job of knowing when to tap down the install into where guys got repetition, repetition, repetition. I think our quarterbacks, you know, by and large, you know, were really effective in knowing where to go with the ball, how quick to go with it. I just thought there was a lot of really good things to it. Really pleased through 15 practices, and we grinded now. I mean, we're rolling most days, 26 periods. You know, if you look at the play count today, there's 130 plays in that today. We've never done that. Like, we really hit the play count at halftime that I was kind of looking for. And that's why we ran the clock the way we did in the second half as much as we did. The pace that we're able to play at right now, the pace that everybody's working at, really pleased. But then now we flip that chapter, right, and go to the next one, and we got to have a great summer and lead into the fall. But there's a big expectation, and the big expectation starts with what I expect from everybody, and I think everybody else expects big things too.
Going back to that last catch, I mean, what can that catch do for a guy like Caden Lockenbrose, for his confidence going into the offseason?
Yeah, you know, I think the great thing with that, you know, 2 weeks ago when we had that open scrimmage on, I guess it was the 6th of April, I guess that'd be 3 weeks ago, getting close to it, he didn't play very well. And you know, I kind of had a little bit higher expectation of some things. You know, Roddy, man, there were some things that he and I talked about on some stuff that we could clean up and everything. And, or that he could do, you know, that do better. And there's just a lot of different things. His last couple weeks of practice have been really good. And at his size and everything else, look, I have an expectation for him. I mean, he's a guy that there's no doubt I could envision be a guy that could play for us at some point in the future. So, you know, yeah, it's so much of it's attitude, right? You know, I mean, when people have a positive image of themselves and a positive image of what they're doing, they improve. You know, that's the biggest piece to it.
So you talked about expectations. Is there anyone during spring ball that really exceeded your expectations that you would like to talk about?
I mean, maybe Chris Durr did, because I had no expectation. I didn't really know how that went. So he was one. You know, like I said, I had no idea what we were getting with DJ Jones. You know, I mean, I knew we were getting a mature player that had played games. I didn't realize he was as good as what he is and as good a person as what he is. Like, I thank him almost every day. I see him like, hey, I tell you what, I love having you here. And he's just got a great attitude. I think, you know, like I said, I think some guys that really, really stood out for the positive, I think Tyrekus Davis had a great spring. I think Sebastian Harsh had a great spring. I think Gavin Meyer has had a great spring. I think Fia has had a great off season and spring and all the things that way. So there's just a lot of people that, you know, I'm happy with right now. And we got to keep going though. That at the end of the day, it flips to tomorrow, and we got to do something good tomorrow.
How about Merritt at corner? Think of him today. I know he's, what, 2 days on the job?
Yeah, you know, I mean, Caleb has a great attitude toward it. Caleb has, you know, I thought even Tuesday, now I got to watch the video from today and everything, but Tuesday he showed the capability to do it. And I think what we've got to really do is look at, like, how that fits within the program. Look, he's mature. I know what I'm getting out of Caleb Merritt. I know what kind of mentality that he's going to have and everything else. And he really does have a defensive mentality. I mean, like, he loves to be physical. He loves to challenge people and things like that. You know, and then I think that also, you know, helps us potentially with any other potential roster move that we might have to do or will do going forward, is based on what we think that he can do. I thought he did some good things out there today. I know he got a pass interference penalty, you know, there toward the end. But I thought there was a lot of plays. I mean, one thing is, when you put a guy out there that hadn't played it before, a lot of times it could just look like they're just keep ringing the bell on the guy, you know. And I didn't feel that with him. I thought he did pretty good. I guess we'll find that out and watch the video and everything else. I mean, it's one of those things that we still have to get better. You know, I mean, I think, look, I'm optimistic in a lot of areas in the football team and things like that, but we still have a couple areas that we've got to get better at before I can sit there and go, you know, have real confidence in everything. So, and that's one area there. And those guys got to turn around and have a really good off season, a really good fall camp, and continue to develop and improve. The thing is, their improvement level is going to have to go faster. But we also know we're missing a starter and some things like that too. But, I mean, there's no time to waste. I mean, we got stuff to do.
Is corner the other one, I assume?
Just depth at corner.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that's, you know, look, I think Tyrekus is a good player. I mean, Keone Parks didn't practice or didn't scrimmage in the spring. Now, he did practice multiple times in the spring, and when you watched him, you're like, okay, this can be a good player here. You know, I think, you know, Ian Bell, you know, he's had got an injury right now that, you know, sets him back a little bit, but that's something that, you know, hopefully he's good in a short order. And then moving Caleb over there, you know, yeah. And then we got three freshmen coming in and that, but I don't want a freshman to have to be number three or something like that. Freshman being your fourth corner, okay, I can live with that. You, when you start counting on freshmen to be any further up the chain, you're starting to live a dangerous line. So.
Can you talk about Clemens 7 completions in a row and really stuck to the tempo.
I tell you what, I thought the one series where he got rolling, I thought that was some of the best football I've ever seen him play. Like, it was, he had a really good command. He got in a rhythm, and once he got in a rhythm, like, he looked really, really good. Look, Jaden Clemens has a role for our football team, and I appreciate his attitude and the mindset that he's brought back this offseason. This was a guy that he and I had a meeting in December, and in that meeting, he just wanted an opportunity, you know, and I granted that to him, and he knew the conditions to it to continue past the spring. He's met those, you know, he's done that, and I appreciate what he's doing right now, and so, you know, I mean, I'm really thankful that he's playing the way